Good morning, Cardano Army. It's your boy Boomin coming at you with yet another video, guys. Go ahead and do all the things that the algorithm likes for me. I got my clean energy drink locked and loaded, ready to go. Let's get this show started. Thank you so much to our wonderful Patreon subscribers, Catherine B. Alpha LLC, Craig and Farouz Den, Maryland for Crypto, and VET Docky. I really appreciate it. Go ahead and join the Patreon Army down below. Click the link as we get in to the bull run. All right, so we got Charles Hoskinson here. This is pretty cool. Ada community, Brazil's gift starts with a challenge for world flags with Cardano's logo. That is sick. I gotta get me one of those. That is sick. Look at that. That is awesome. We got Charles here. Shout out to him. Let's go ahead and see what he has to say.
This was a gift when we attended the SIP 1694 workshop in Edinburgh, Scotland, from the Latin American Cardano community. So I want to say obrigado to the Brazilian Cardano community. We know that you guys love us so much that you decided to put the Cardano logo within the Brazilian flag, and we decided to actually hang it in the office. So it's going to be permanently here. And I think this is now a challenge that the Brazilian Cardano community has put to all the Cardano community. So if you want, put our logo, the Cardano logo, on the flag, send it to us here at the office in Colorado, and we will try to find a wall to put it up on. I suspect we'll have flags from as many countries as one can imagine. So thank you so much, Brazilian Cardano community. We really appreciate it from the bottom of our heart, and this is always going to be a reminder of how amazing that event was. Cheers.
That's pretty sick. I like that flag. If we could get like a Japanese version of that, that'd be lit. See, me, I like flags. I like all kinds of flags. You know, even the flags that aren't politically correct alike, I like them. I like how they look. Like the Canadian flag, that'd be lit. Like if we can get a Cardano logo right there, oh man, that'd be awesome. So yeah, that's pretty cool. Shout out to Brazil. Yeah, I thought that was pretty nice. Anyway, that's minor news. Let's go ahead and move on. Nothing too crazy going on in the Cardano ecosystem today, guys. But, you know, we got some updates. Eternal Wallet. I love that wallet. I highly recommend Eternal Wallet. It's worked perfectly for me. The UI is a little bit, you know, basic, but I like it. It's very easy to navigate. But they are releasing a big update, a major update. It's a complete overhaul of Eternal's core. I don't think they should fix it. If it ain't broke, don't fix it. That's what I say. But it seems as though, you know, they got some stuff that they want to upgrade on it. But complete overhaul of Eternal Wallet. Highly recommend it. Smaller memory footprint, way faster syncing. I mean, the syncing's pretty fast. It syncs once every 15 seconds. Smaller database packed with new features. You can help test it out by going to beta.eternal.io. Any feedback is welcome. We're looking to release this new milestone and go ahead full steam ahead with Eternal 2.0. So, you know, I already like it. You know, it doesn't really need to be fixed. Like, you could connect to any dApp. We've done full tutorials of Eternal Wallet. I've done full tutorials on how to buy SNEC token, how to do DeFi. So, you know, I'm glad they're upgrading it. But it doesn't need to be. It ain't broke. So don't fix it. I'm afraid that they're going to tinker and tinker and tinker, and then, you know, stuff's going to stop breaking and it's going to stop being as smooth as it already is. I mean, you guys know me. I've tried Daedalus. I've tried, Nami. I've tried most of the wallets on Cardano, and Eternal is just the most consistent. So it's easy to connect with Ledger. Like, it's just, you know, yeah. So this is Eternal. They're going to be doing updates. Let's go ahead and move on. Thank you to OneCom. You know the drill, guys. Keep Cardano decentralized, please. All right, we need to prove Gary Gensler wrong, all right? We need to prove Gary Gensler wrong. So shout out to OneCom, ticker symbol 1COMM. You guys know the drill. Follow One Community Ada on Twitter, Cardano Crypto News. Community knows 0% fees till at least the end of December 2023 for all existing and new delegators. There's millions of Cardano tokens just out in the ether, not earning any of that sweet, sweet passive income, and it's wrong. Okay, it's wrong. So please, for the love of God, make sure, even if you don't delegate with OneCom, please just make sure that you're delegating, period. Okay? My dog just loves to bark right when I'm doing a video. She hears other dogs outside, and she's a small dog, so it's like she thinks she's a big one. I don't really understand. Like, she thinks she's such a big dog, and it's like you're very tiny, and if a dog wanted to, they could eat you in one bite. But she thinks she's a pit bull or a Rottweiler, so... Anyway, back on my spiel here. 0% fees. Delegate to OneCom. You already know. Let's go ahead and move on, guys. Alright, so Lace got some updates. As we're talking about Eternal Wallet, you know, Lace is obviously probably going to be one of the premier wallets on Cardano because it's made by IOG. So Lace Wallet has launched in April this year, and highly functional, easy to use Web3 wallet to cater to the needs of every user within the ecosystem and beyond. With the wallet operational, Cardano is leaving no stone unturned to ensure Lace operates as best it can. So in the protocol's weekly development highlight, it has been revealed the team is working on Lace, embarked on a number of fixes, including the semi-automatic collateral setup for CIP30. Refactored complex areas of code, increased the end-to-end test automation coverage, and started looking closer into CIP95 ahead of work related to Voltaire. According to this report, Lace team also took the liberty on working on the UI flow for multi-delegation, ran load tests on the backend using HD wallets. The updates to the Lace did not come as a shock. Charles Hoskinson teased the updates. So that is pretty cool. Cardano developers keep building. Yes, they do. Cardano prides itself being on one of the top blockchains in the Web3 world with the active developer base. In the weekly Cardano update, is revealed that 135 projects have launched on the protocol. This total project count was complemented by more than 71 million transactions. That's crazy. They've been working on every aspect of Cardano, such as Hydra, Mithril, Daedalus, amongst others. So this is awesome. And Charles Hoskinson extended a hard sell offer to the Algorand protocol to become one of its side chains as well. I don't know what happened to Algo, man. Algo was on top of the world, and then it just, poof, it went away. I don't know what happened, so... It might be prudent for Algorand to consider becoming a sidechain to Cardano. Always here to help. So I would agree. I would agree. I think that would be a good marriage there. And hopefully, yeah. Rest in peace, Algo. All right, guys. Finally here. We have a Twitter space here. Charles Hoskinson is talking. It's about Circle. Let's take a look at what he has to say.
Circle says that they're not doing or not planning anything for Cardano because there are no developers on Cardano. Or not no developers, but there's not a lot of developers. How come we have an industry?
Your source is a bull-faced liar. Your source is a bull-faced liar. The reason why they're not deploying is that the foundation won't pay them the eight-figure amount that they want to deploy. It has absolutely nothing to do with the amount of developer adoption. It has everything to do with pay-to-play. So that's just, it's just wrong. I know because I've been directly party to these things. That's how these business models work. You know, and that's the problem with this industry is people lie. There's 1,200 projects building on Cardano, 100 of which have already launched. We're, I think, number five or six for all overall blockchain developers. We've absorbed the entire functional programming space. And there's a huge amount of people doing things and building things. So it's just a bull-faced lie to say there's no development activity. We're number two for NFTs. That alone should justify a stablecoin because of the transaction volume they can get. A, it's difficult to deploy on extended UTXO and give all the things that they want to do, like freezing and reversibility, so it requires extra development effort and time to reason through, and B, the foundation didn't want to do pay-to-play.
So it looks like Circle is, you know, running a pay-to-play scheme here, you know, which I get it. They got to make money in order to integrate USDC, but eight figures? Eight figures? Are you kidding me? That's insane. That is insane. You know, it's crazy. I don't even know what to say to that. It's
Circle says that they're not doing or not planning anything.
You know, I'd rather we build our own stablecoin from the ground up and promote it and get it on DEXs and get it cross chain and. You know, if we're just a better, faster, cheaper stablecoin to use, then people are going to use us. They just need to know about it. So that's all I got for today, guys. Keep chopping wood. Thank you so much to Catherine Bialflat, LC Kraken, Fruzden, Maryland for Crypto, and VET Docky. We're going to win. We're coming for number one. Cardano will prevail. I'm going to go watch some UFC now. Take care, guys. Bye.